Thank you.
Good evening,
ladies. That's how we stopped when we came on.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the show.
Yes.
Not only we would like to wish you a good evening, we'd also like to wish you all a very Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to every one of you.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Lovely, that.
And now, without getting too sentimental...
Oh, yes?
I'd like to wish a very Merry Christmas to my very best friend, my number one buddy, Merry Christmas, Charlie. Merry Christmas. Hope you're watching the show, Charlie. Merry Christmas.
Charlie?
Do you know what I like about Christmas?
Best?
No, no.
Charlie?
No, no. What I like best... What I like best about Christmas is everybody gives one another presents.
So I'm told.
They just give one another presents.
I have heard that.
They say, Merry Christmas, old friend. And they swap presents.
So I'm told. Mm. It's an old custom, you know.
Yes, it is.
Dating from way back.
Yes.
Like you and me.
Mm. It isn't so much the present. It's the feeling of not being forgotten.
Of course.
Especially by an old friend.
Isn't that nice? You see, it's a thought that counts.
Of course.
That's the most important thing.
Yes.
Look at your face.
Look at my face, yeah, I know.
Do you know who you remind me of when you look like that?
Who?
You're the double of Minnie Caldwell. At this moment, you look like Minnie Caldwell in a trouser suit.
You've forgotten, haven't you?
How could I forget you at Christmas?
You've forgotten to get me a Christmas present.
No. I see your lead hanging on that door. I think to myself, it's Walkers this afternoon. I'll tell you what.
What?
You're in for a surprise.
You've got me a...
No, a shock, I would say.
Yeah?
Turn around. No peeping now.
All right.
Close your eyes.
I've closed my eyes.
And I've got for you...
Brownie's honour.
Brownie's honour?
Yeah.
That's fair enough for me.
Mm-hmm.
Turn.
Yeah.
Turn around now. Merry Christmas. Oh, friend. And pal, oh, my. What's this? I bought you a pair of socks for Christmas.
But they're still warm.
Ah, yes.
You've just taken those socks off.
I was airing them for you. I don't want you to catch a chill, do I?
What sort of a Christmas present is that?
What are you talking about? It's well, what you gave me, isn't it? What do you give me? A quick hello to Charlie, that's all you gave me. Nothing. I know you from the... Well, you want to post it?
It's my Christmas present. From me to you. Merry Christmas, Eric. Something you've always wanted.
Good Lord. Look at that. That is beautiful, eh?
You like it?
Oh, look, I feel terrible about the socks.
Oh, no, it was the thought that counts.
No, really.
About the socks. It's lovely, isn't it?
You can have my shoes. Have my jacket. Oh, have my jacket as well.
I like that tie.
Say no more. Yours, eh?
Thank you very much.
That is knockout, yes.
It's a musical watch.
A musical watch?
A musical.
Most expensive.
There's lots of things I'd like to say to you. I've wanted to say to you over the years.
Really?
Well, seeing as it's Christmas.
Yeah?
Look at me when I'm talking to you.
I was then at the time.
Yes.
I said it earlier, I wasn't then. Sitting in the same place every time, you see. That's the trouble.
I don't want to sound...
I was looking at the watcher and I was thrilled with it. Thrilled I am.
I don't want to sound too sentimental.
Too sentimental?
No. But that's a musical watch.
Yes, I know that.
And the tune that watch plays says it all for me.
Really?
Open up the back. We have just put 1 gallon of economy petrol in this gentleman's car. Let's see how far he can go on 1 gallon of economy petrol. Right, off you go, sir.
Pardon?
Off you go. Sorry!
Yes, all right, sorry.
Thank you very much. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have some community singing. We're going to start with your old favorite, I'll Be Your Sweetheart. Here we go. One, two, three.
Give us a hand with him.
What?
Give us a hand with
him. We're doing the community singing.
Oh, yes. What?
I'll Be Your Sweetheart.
Well, that's very kind, but I am spoken for. Will you open the tap, please? Just open the curtain. Here we are.
What's the box for?
Well, I'll tell you. This being Christmas.
Yes.
And the festive season. And Christmas parties. Mm-hmm. I thought I would do a party trick.
What sort of a party trick?
Sawing a woman in half.
Hey, that's a very good idea. That should be good.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Get in the box.
I'm not a woman.
I haven't used a saw yet. Are you going to do it?
Yes. No, certainly not. I'm not getting in there.
Well, all right, then.
It's frightening in there.
Stand on your head, we'll do it the hard way.
Yeah.
Oh, go on.
No, I'm not getting
in there. Open it.
Let's have a look.
Well, what do you think of it?
Right, it's
a good idea, though, isn't it?
You're not going to get me in there, that's all I can say. That's all I'm going to say.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. And that's before I've done it. Yes?
It's Peter Cushing. Do you remember he played the part of King Arthur in that sketch once?
Yes.
I'm most awfully sorry to trouble you like this.
Still on the margarine?
He didn't get paid, you see. We didn't pay him his money. That's what he's come for.
Who does on our shorts? Who does?
You may recall that some considerable time ago, I appeared in one of your entertainments as King Arthur in an historical play. I believe it was written by Mr. Wilde.
He's the one.
Yes, yes, that was one of my finest plays, and I thought you were first class, Mr. Cushing.
Thanks, very, very mediocre.
I'm very sorry to have to take this attitude, but I come for my money.
Yes.
You keep fobbing me off with excuses every time I ask for payment.
Oh.
I demand to be reimbursed.
Well, I'm not a medical man, but I don't know a fella in Salt.
No, no. Reimbursed. He wants the loot. The money.
Ah, well, yes. Now, you and I could... Would you just sit down for a moment, Peter?
Down,
please. It's a long walk from Whistable.
Of course.
Sit down. Get your legs up and rest.
Yes, have a little rest.
Put your legs up. Good Lord. Get your head down like that. That's a good chap.
Yeah, just relax nice.
My God, yes, there we are.
There we are.
Hey, ready? Ladies and gentlemen, sawing a Peter Cushing in half.
What about my money?
You'll get your cut.
Hello, Dolly. Well, hello, Dolly. It's so nice to have you back where you belong. You're looking swell, Dolly. We can tell, Dolly. You're still growing, you're still growing, you're still going strong. I feel the room swaying, 'cause the band's playing one of our old favorite songs from way back when.
Do you realise this is the first time we've invited Anne Hamilton round for Christmas dinner?
Is it really?
Yeah.
She's worked with us for 45 years, poor kid.
Yes, it's true.
It's not right, you know.
No, it's...
Anyway, one thing.
What?
She's in for a treat, I'll
is
tell
she
you
really?
That. Good Lord, yeah. We've got it all here. One of those things, I'll tell you. It'll be a beautiful meal, this. Beautiful. She might not get it, but we'll all get a piece.
I hope you know what you're doing. That's our Christmas dinner, that is.
Well, I know.
Don't forget, I went out and bought the chicken myself.
First time earning your whole life that you've ever been out on your own looking for a bird.
That's a good one, that is.
Oh.
Don't ruin it, that's all.
No, it's all there.
What?
Chicken.
Yeah.
Peas. Beans.
Beans.
Brussels sprouts. Potatoes. Cabbage. Cabbage. You name it. We've got it.
Better than sardines on toast, eh?
Oh, good Lord, what isn't? Remember those digs in pantomime?
Yeah.
Frightening, there, weren't
they? Frightening?
Sardines on toast, yes. I don't forget it.
Don't ruin it, that's
no,
all.
No, no, I've been watching that fella on television.
Who?
Danny Craddock. Had it all off.
Who?
Danny Craddock.
Fanny Craddock.
Well, it's his own fault. For shutting the oven door too quickly. Go on.
What?
How do you like potatoes?
On a plate, please.
Sit down.
What's the matter?
Sit down. How do you like potatoes, huh?
On a plate, please.
Is that it now?
Yeah.
That's your Christmas joke over with, is it?
Yeah.
You won't do another one till next year?
No, I won't bother.
Promise me? I'm not going to do it this way this time.
No.
That makes a change.
All I ask is don't ruin that Christmas
dinner. Leave it to me. Yeah. I've got everything off to a tear. We haven't done that for weeks.
No, I know.
We haven't done this one either.
No.
Sit there, my feet. No.
No. Just stop the jokes and concentrate on that dinner.
You're right.
That'll be Anne.
Eh?
That'll be Anne.
Princess or Hamilton?
Anne Hamilton.
Well, just one second.
You. How?
God, whatever you do, don't put the baby in there. He's too hot. Why can't you go let her in? I'm busy, aren't I?
I'm blowing up these balloons, aren't I?
That's true. That's true. I'll go let her in there. Kill. You were right, it was her.
But don't leave her standing there. Let her in, for goodness sake.
Let her in as well.
Well, of course.
Oh, did you realize, huh?
Really ought to be ashamed of
come
this.
In, son.
Happy Christmas, Anne.
And a merry, happy, merry Christmas to you as well.
Happy Christmas, Anne.
And a merry, happy New Year as well.
Happy New Year.
A merry Christmas, happy New Year.
Oh, and a merry, happy birthday, Christmas birthday wish.
Pack it in.
Where's the presents?
What, there?
Don't be rude.
I thought they were both for me, Ellie.
It's the big one for me.
Yes, it is, Ernie. I was going to buy you some aftershave lotion, only Eric told me you hadn't started shaving yet.
That's right.
Just his legs. Just his legs,
just
once a month.
Legs.
When he does the Scottish country dance. Do
I'll do the Scottish country dance.
See? People down below love this.
Yes,
yes. Oh, I do hope you like it, Ernie.
Oh, I'm all right.
Eric said it might be just what you wanted.
Yeah.
He suggested it.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Mm. Yeah. Look at his little face. He's all lit up now, isn't he? He lost Christmas, you know.
I do.
Hung his sock up last night.
He did.
In the living room.
Do you like it, Ernie?
Just what I've always wanted.
Well,
Anne.
There you are.
Trust you to suggest something like this.
Well, you've got to put it somewhere, haven't you?
Duh.
It frightens me to death in the morning, lying across my face.
Ah.
Is that mine? Oh, hey.
I do hope you like it, Eric.
I'll be thrilled with it, whatever it is. I really will. Oh, that's gorgeous. What is it?
It's a tie, isn't it?
Eh?
It's a tie.
Oh, yeah. Beautiful.
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 Oh,
I'm knocked out with that.
Love.
I'll tell you for why. It'll go so well with all the others you bought. Shot making a fortune, someone. Yeah? Don't keep doing that. You'll knock it off one day.
No, listen. We forgot to buy Anne a present, haven't we? Christmas present.
Well, I gave you the three bob.
I know. You've got the chicken with that.
Oh.
What are we going to do? She'd be very upset, you
well,
know.
Look, leave it to me.
Be tactful.
Use a bit of tact. Okay. Don't hurt her feelings. But she's a nice girl. Anne?
Yes?
We forgot to buy you a Christmas present.
Yeah, no! Use a bit of tact. Yeah, he's got a lovely present for
oh,
you.
Of course.
Of course we have. We yes. wouldn't forget you, Anne.
Oh,
yes.
Good Lord,
Eric
no.
went out specially to get it.
Did I?
Yes.
Yes. Mm. Well,
oh.
Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and all you wish yourself. What do you think?
It's beautiful.
It is, isn't it?
Just what I always wanted.
We broke a setup for that.
Yes.
Just try it. Try it. See what happens. Does it fit?
Yes,
sir. Well, it does. That's genuine cedar wood, that.
Cedar wood?
Just chip away the paint, you can see the wood. It's a joke chair, you see. You sit on that and you do jokes if you're lucky.
She's not laughing.
Hey?
You go see to the dinner and I'll get Anna a drink.
Oh.
Get your drink, Jan. Right.
Eric, can I help you with the dinner?
No, you can't. No. I'll tell you for why, because this is for real. This is genuine, this is. It's all Gordon Blue, this.
Cordon Bleu.
I'm not surprised the way Keith blowing up that balloon.
Eric, have you done a Christmas pudding with sixpences in it?
No, we haven't. Have we? Aww.
What?
Done a Christmas pudding with sixpences in it?
No, because we think it's unhygienic and very bad.
Yeah, I'll tell you what we have done. We saved up all our World Cup coins and put them in the pudding instead.
Yeah.
Because I want to see the look on his face when he swallows Bobby Moore.
Bobby Moore, yeah. You can have a tin can?
Yes, please.
All right, there we are today. Now, what about you, Eric?
Hey, no, not for me. I'm too busy over there.
All right. Well, bottoms up.
Don't keep saying things like that in front of the young lady. She doesn't like that. It's not nice. Good, well, I'm surprised at you, aren't you?
Sorry.
Please, can I help you with the dinner, Eric?
No, you can't. Get off.
How's the chicken coming along, Eric?
Fine.
Good.
Where do you keep the salt?
In the cellar.
In the cellar. Can I top you up, Ann?
I keep warning you. Don't see things. What do you mean? I'm sorry
about
that.
There, I'll have a little drop more.
Thank you.
Hey, I'll tell you something. This is smashing stuff, this is. I love it, you know. Oh,
Oh, it is, don't it?
No, what?
Ginger wine.
Ginger wine?
Another two glasses. They'll be asking you if you can try your shoes on. 3.5 dozen bottles at Christmas it goes through.
3.5 dozen bottles of ginger wine?
At Christmas. Gets it wholesale from Daly LaRue.
I fancied a leg of pork this Christmas, Eric.
You watch this. Pardon?
I fancied a leg of pork this Christmas, Eric.
What's the point? You go all ready for mention crackling.
Can I try your shoes on, Anne?
You see what I mean? I wouldn't let him. You could end up stripped.
How long's dinner going to be?
4 inches. It's a sausage.
He didn't have come out with some funny ones. It makes me laugh all the time, man, honestly.
Shall I put the plates on the table, Eric?
Where else?
Would you like to pull my cracker, Anne?
I'm warning you.
Give it a good judge, Anne.
Right. Are you ready for your potatoes?
Yes, please.
Sit down, then. Here they are, done to perfection.
Are they King Edward's?
No, they're ours. Hey. He's gone, he's had enough. He's in the Himalayas now, looking for his dad. He'll find him.
Christmas dinner.
What are you talking about? Everything's in flaming tins now.
Oh, you brought
it. Oh, shut up. What's the matter with you?
What's it got to do with you anyway?
But I adored
it. Oh, never mind the door tin potatoes. How's that chicken then coming along? I hope you haven't ruined it. Is it done yet?
I'll have a look. Almost.
It's going well up to now, isn't it, Eric?
What?
It's going well up to now.
The show?
Yes.
Oh, great.
Lovely audience, you
know. Oh, beautiful audience.
And now, ladies and gentlemen...
No, leave them happy as they are asleep. Don't waken them up, whatever you do. They're happy now.
Yes, they are.
And while they're in this condition, I should do a trick for you.
A trick?
Yes.
Not another one.
Life is like that.
Of course.
What is that?
A red snooker ball.
Close. You hold that in your right hand.
Mm-hmm.
Have you got it?
Yes.
Now swallow it.
I'm not going to swallow that.
Oh, well, if you're not going to help me, I can't do the flaming tricks, can I?
Do something else.
Well, put it behind your back.
Right.
And count up to three.
1, 2, 3.
What do you think of that?
That's absolutely marvellous.
It's done me no good, but it's a good trick, isn't it?
Yes.
Let's be honest.
It's a magnificent trick.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
I pulled up the other red
bullet. Yeah. Yeah. Hello. How do you go? A drunk. The drunk just come up.
Drunk?
Just play cool, don't worry about it.
All right, just ignore him.
Don't you remember me?
No, sir, no, I never seen
him. I was on your show a few weeks ago.
Oh, they all say that.
Yeah. No, I know I've grown the beard since then, but surely you recognise
me. You were that bad, were you?
No, I'm
sorry. Hey.
Yeah, what?
It's not the one that comes down at the end and everybody said, who is he?
No. Could you give us a clue, sir?
A clue?
A clue, yes, please.
Well, right, Oh, Mr. Porter, what shall I do? I wanted to go to Birmingham and they've taken me off to crew. Murray Lloyd. Is it Murray Lloyd?
No. Would you just leave your name and address, sir? And
well, look, supposing I were to say foresight. You can say that if you want. It's a nice word, that.
Nice word.
Have you always foresight?
No,
not rude, is it?
No, it's not.
Foresight, it can say foresight. That is not rude.
It's not rude, is it?
Foresight? What? Yeah, of course he can. Yeah, you can say it. The three stages.
Saga.
Oh, you can't say that. That's rude.
No.
That is rude. I'm sorry about that, lads. Three of them put the coats on and gone home. I'm sorry, boys.
Shouldn't say saga.
Well, what can I say?
Well, what
not
can
a lot. Figure something.
Well, who are you? I don't know who you are.
What's your
Eric? Eric?
Eric? Yes, you called?
Porter. Eric Porter, of
course. Yeah, you remember
yes,
now.
Of course.
I don't want him on. He was rotten the last time.
This is Eric Porter.
Oh, delighted to see. Delighted to see.
Well, it was Christmas and I was passing, so I thought I'd just come round and say a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Isn't that a lovely
thought? That's what I like.
The festive season.
Merry Christmas to you.
And a Merry
Goodwill to all men.
And I'd ask for a job.
Get off.
Now, where were we?
A famous actor like you looking for work?
Well, I'm in dire straits.
I played there. It's on the Welsh coast.
I played there.
I'm sorry, sir. We haven't got an opening for you.
Well, look, I don't mind what it is.
Oh?
Now, I pride myself that I can turn my hand to quite a lot of things.
I have heard that. I have heard that.
Well, I don't know what... I mean, with a beard like that, you shouldn't have any difficulty getting work.
That's true. I'll tell you what. I'll promise you one thing. If we need a busted sofa, I'll give you a ring. Now, that can't be
right. No, that can't be right. That's fine. Oh, look, you've upset him now, Eric. It is Christmas. You've got to be nice to him.
Possibly.
I tell you what. We've never had any Shakespeare on the show, have we?
Up to now.
You like a bit of Shakespeare?
That's plenty. Thank you very much.
All right, no, wait, but just let me think. Just let me think.
Well, it's not my fault, is it?
Get these people on.
If they could see me now, that little gang of mine, I'm eating fancy chow and drinking fancy wine. I'd like those stumble bums to see for a fact the sort of top draw first class chums I attract. All I can say is while we look at where I am, my feet have landed, pow, right in the pot of jam. What a setup! Holy cow, they'll never believe it if my friends could see me now. Shop cats say, brother, get him draped on a bed spread made from three kinds of skin. All I can say is, wow, wait till the riff and rap. See just exactly how I sign my autograph. What a setup! Holy cow, they'll never believe it if my friends could see me now.
You've been up to your tricks again.
rings of angels' hair and ice cream castles in the air and feather canyons everywhere. I've looked at clouds that way, but now they only block the sun. They rain and snow on everyone. So many things I would have done, but clouds got in my way. I've looked at clouds from all sides now, from up and down, and still somehow it's clouds illusion I recall. I really don't know clouds at all. And dunes and fairies' wheels, the dizzy dancing way you feel as every fairy tale comes real. I've looked at love that way, but now it's just another show. You leave them laughing when you go, and if you care, don't let them know. Don't give yourself away. I've looked at love from all sides now, from give and take, and still somehow it's love's illusion I recall. I really don't know love at all. Tears and fears and feeling proud to say I love you right out loud. Dreams and schemes and circus crowds, I've looked at life that way. But now my friends are acting strange. They shake their heads, they say I've changed. But something's lost and something's gained in living every day. Life from all sides now, from win and lose, and still somehow it's life's illusion I recall. I really don't know life at all.
That was a beautiful song, beautifully sung.
Thank you very much.
Pleasure.
Nina, how wonderful to see you again.
Thank you.
Now, while you're here, will you do me a big favor? Will you sing a song for us?
I don't understand.
You can sing that one if you wish. But I've just been watching over there on a television set. And there's a fellow just did an impression of you that was terrible. I saw it. This fellow comes on. Just like that.
What are you talking about?
Well, what I'm saying is, we ought to have a good song because Cilla Black has just had Frank Sinatra on her show.
Oh, that's true, yes. Yes, that's true. Frank
He's
Sinatra.
He's a wonderful artist.
Isn't wonderful he a wonderful artist? Artist?
Wonderful artist.
He's the one who sings I Did It My Way.
Yes. That probably accounts for the limp.
Yes.
Well, it's probably Nancy Sinatra
that's
as well.
Quite possible.
However...
Nina, we'd like you to sing a seasonal song.
Yes, but not about your own home country and things like that. You know, you can keep that. We'll keep a welcome. We don't want that.
No, we don't want that.
Because we've got Lou Grake coming on in a minute singing If I Rule the World.
As a matter of fact, I've built a special set. All the scenery and everything. Eric and I have been working like mad, and we've built it specially
built it for you.
A
special set over there.
You see, I got a carpentry set for Christmas.
And the nurse's outfit. Don't forget the nurse's outfit.
Oh, yes. And the nurse's outfit.
Let Red Cross for his fingers.
Yes.
Well, really, if you've gone to the trouble building scenery and everything else, I can hardly refuse to sing, can I?
You can't, can you?
Yeah.
So give us a kiss and get off.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's Nina singing the Christmas song.
Chestnuts roasting in an open fire,
Jack Frost sniffing at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up as Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. Loaded lots of toys of kittens on his sleigh, and every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase.
Can ask me when Eric slaps me across the face whether it really hurts me. Well, I can honestly say it does. What?
About a silence.
That was yes, if.
And look at me while I'm saying it.
Yes.
If I was to ask you, if I was to ask you, in your opinion, who is the greatest cowboy?
Cowboy.
The greatest cowboy that Hollywood has ever produced. Who would you say?
Who would I say? Let me think now. Of course, there's only one. John Wayne.
Who?
John Wayne, the greatest cowboy that ever lived.
Ladies and gentlemen.
You haven't got him.
Pardon?
You haven't got John Wayne back there. No. In the studio. He's come all the way to appear in the studio. You must be kidding.
Hey?
You're kidding?
That's my living.
Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce you now to the greatest cowboy Hollywood has ever produced, Mr. John Wayne. Huh?
What?
It's John Wayne. John Wayne. Little Ernie what?
Howdy.
That's not John Wayne. He doesn't look a bit like John Wayne.
Ah, well, they all look different now, don't they? With the makeup and everything.
Makeup?
They change the makeup in Hollywood. They're all different, off.
Get away.
Well, of course they are.
That's not John Wayne. What?
This man was flown here to be here with us. I'm telling him. He's flown to be with us in Big Iron Bird.
It's not John Wayne.
And you are looking at the fastest draw ever.
The fastest draw?
Yes. Want to see him do it again?
Yeah, let's see him do it again.
Do it again.
Do it again.
But he's mean, this one.
Mean?
Now, I'll tell you what.
Well, what films has he appeared in?
He's been in them all.
All of them?
You remember the good, the bad, and the ugly?
Which one was he?
Well, he wasn't good, he wasn't bad, but hellfire, he was ugly.
Howdy.
Howdy. Yes.
Being here,
hey, look, us being here. He loves our country and everything.
Has he come from Hollywood?
Hey, Cricklewood.
Oh, Cricklewood. Yeah.
We're making it all up as we go along, and yeah. It sounds like it.
Yes.
John! This is a deaf head, is it?
Howdy!
Can't be it now. John! I want you to go behind curtain. Curtain!
Curtain.
You see? Get on big stallion! Pardon the expression? I can't speak with forked tongue. Climb on horse! Climb on horse! And ride off into sunset!
Howdy!
Ready when you are, John? Boot Hill?
Yeah, Boot Hill.
I like you. Why don't you come over here? We could have a lot of fun. Come on. Don't be shy. I'm all alone here in the bushes. If you come with me, I can promise you that you won't be disappointed.
Now, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, it's with great pleasure I'd like to introduce you to our special guest star, Mr. Edward Woodward. Mr. Woodward. Edward. Edward, it really is a great pleasure to have you on the show.
Thank you. Yes, it's nice to be here. Oh, rubbish. We're all in it for the same thing, money. Yes, talking of money.
Money?
Money? Who mentioned money? Nobody said anything about
it. Nobody mentioned money?
I was on one of your shows once before, if you remember. I still haven't been paid for it.
Excuse me.
Yes, sir.
I suggest that you try and find Peter Cushing.
Yes.
Peter Cushing.
Yes.
He's walking around somewhere. He's in a haze.
Yes.
But he's walking around.
He doesn't know whether he's King Arthur, Sherlock Holmes, or the Vampire Bat.
No. But if you see him, you'll know which one he is.
I have.
Well, you'll either get knighted, be given the clue, or he'll bite you in the neck. It's one of all three. You see?
I suppose you've come along here, Edward, to ask if you can appear in one of my plays.
Oh, you must be joking.
Not
after the last time, no, thank you.
The last time?
Oh.
You know, I've decided perhaps I would sing tonight.
Oh.
Yes.
Right. For a change? It's a good idea. You can't act.
You're going to sing? Watch it. Oh.
Get off. Start that with me, I'll throw him at you.
Yes. I'm hard.
He's hard, all right, I'll tell you that.
Mr. Wise, perhaps you would care to introduce me.
Certainly. This is Eric. Eric, this is Edward.
Oh, I tell you.
No, it's the song I'm going to sing. And listen,
yes.
I've just been watching. You're not going to start pulling things, you know, back behind my face when I'm singing. It's serious.
Oh,
I'm going to sing it straight.
There'll be no comedy.
Thank you very much.
No, we won't do any comedy.
You'll
get enough laughs on your own. You'll be all right. Great for you.
Thank you.
We'll see you in a minute. Yeah.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, here's Mr. Edward Woodward to sing for you The Way You Look Tonight.
That's the one that goes The Way You Look Tonight. Probably. Never thought it was good and lovely. That's the way you look tonight. Perform. You're lovely. Never thought you'd be, never wanted me, never going to be, because you're lovely. That's the way you look tonight. Bum, bum.
You know it?
No, I don't know that one.
Someday, when I'm awfully low and the world is cold, I will feel a glow just thinking of you and the way you look. Tonight. with your smile so warm and your cheek so soft. There is nothing for me but to love you just the way you look tonight. Fears apart, and that laugh that wrinkles your nose touches my foolish heart. Never change. Keep that breathless charm. Darling, please arrange it, 'cause I love you just the way you look tonight. Just the way.
One of the greatest writers in the world, both here and everywhere else in the world, once said, "It's not the actors in the play that matter, it's the words that they speak." And I meant it. And so, ladies and gentlemen, for my actors... Yes?
Huh?
What?
What?
Why are we dressed like this?
Exactly. Why are we dressed like this?
Because this is my latest...
I was going to get to it eventually.
Yeah, I know, eventually.
Don't give me any time.
Because we are going to do my latest play, The Three Musketeers.
Well, I've said it once, and I'll say it again.
My plays are brilliant.
To me, you are the Christopher Wren of the ballpoint pen. In my opinion, this play that you have just written is nothing short of not bad.
Well, as a matter of fact, the original work was rather a dull story called The Three Musketeers.
Yes.
By two unknown French writers called Alexandre and Dumas.
That's true.
I think they'll be very pleased with my little effort.
They're knocked out with it.
They're knocked out with
I've
it?
I've just been on the phone now to them, both. Alexandre and Dumas. On the phone.
On the
France. Yes.
But they've been dead for 100 years.
They were faint. I'll give you that, they were faint.
Faint. Well, now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce you to our special guest star, a very famous face on the television screen, Mr. William Franklin. Mr. Franklin, I can only say I'm absolutely overjoyed to have you on the show, as I know you must be.
Well, Ernie, I'm delighted to be here. When you rang me and asked me to be in your play, I was so excited I fell asleep for an hour and a half.
That's one of the nicest things anybody's ever said to me.
I mean, only a half-wit would turn down an offer like this.
Have you met Eric?
I turned it down, you know.
Yes.
Well, Bill, you know the word, so you don't mind if I call you Bill?
No, not at all.
You can call me Mr. Wise.
No, thank you.
If you just go and get ready, Bill, we're all ready to start.
I can't wait.
I turned it down, you know.
Look, will you go and let Mr. Franklin go and get ready, for goodness sake?
Oh.
I mean, after all, he's got other jobs to do besides this.
You're kept busy, then.
Oh, a bit of this, a bit of that.
Bit of lemon.
Hey?
What a lovely actor that man is.
I think you've upset him now, you know.
Really?
Well, he doesn't want any reference to you-know-what.
Would you we're not allowed to say anything about you or know what on television anyway.
Yes, I know that. Well, we don't want to.
Well, I won't. I'll promise you.
You promise me? I know your promises. What?
Now, let's be honest. Have I ever let you down?
No, never.
Have I? Have I ever told you a lie?
No, never.
Have I ever, in the 7 decades that we've been together, have I ever tried to get a cheap laugh at your expense?
No, never.
This boy's a fool.
Ladies and gentlemen, by Alexandre Dumas, The Three Musketeers.
Thank you.
Open the curtain.
This way, Your Majesty. Ah, sacre bleu, there is not a soul in sight.
What's going on?
The Three Musketeers was all in their power.
What's wrong?
See,
what's going on?
He's gone.
What's the rush for?
Well, I thought as soon as the curtains opened, I had to get on with it. I mean, I didn't want to hang about.
He knows nothing.
Gosh,
this isn't a commercial all over with within 15 seconds. Give us the money and go home.
No,
I'm terribly sorry.
This is for real. He's worked very hard.
I have. You've got to set the mood, you know.
Hey, don't you interfere.
Well, you know.
You get cut of the way, you do, you'll hit him.
I will.
I know you. Now, look, I'll tell you what I want you to do, son. Go off, and when we give you the cue, you come on.
What's the cue?
Eh?
What's the cue?
I'll shout. Come on, Bill.
All right. That's
I'm very sorry.
Yeah, okay. Get the fellow to close the curtains.
Right, would you close the curtains? These fellows, they drive you mad, there, don't they?
Where do you get these amateurs from?
I don't know. Here, why did he say sacre bleu when he came on?
Don't worry about it. He's French for paraffin oil. He knows nothing, that fellow.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we'll start again with the Three Musketeers.
Just a moment. Are you in this?
Yes.
The 2½ Musketeers. Off you go.
All right.
This way, Your Majesty. There's not a soul in sight. The Three Musketeers will do all in their power to protect Your Majesty's honor.
You mean the Queen is here? Oh, mercy, mercy, mercy.
If you value your life, you will keep a still tongue in your head.
Anything you say, my lord. Shh. Ah, of course.
It is quite safe, Your Majesty. A rest a while. You must be weary after your long ride.
Yes, indeed I am.
Shh.
The landlord, my name is Athos. I have brought this lady here to await the arrival of my two comrades.
Athos, two comrades? Mon Dieu, it is the Three Musketeers!
Shh! Hark! Horsemen approach!
Big Dutch stallion!
It's Eric and Porthos and Aramis. They've ridden hard through the night, and here they come now.
Evening all.
I wish you'd get a proper horse.
Landlord! Both. Landlord, give this young man some bran mash and he'll rub down with a wire brush. Put a poultice on his left fetlock if you can find it.
Sorry.
It's good to see you both again, my brave comrade.
That's me finished. I'm off. I don't want to know about that.
Hey,
what do you mean? What do you mean?
Well, he's only acting, that's
acting?
All.
Acting? He's got soft lips, I'll tell you that.
Soft lips? Wait! Thank you!
We're the Three Musketeers, bold and brave are we. I'm Athos.
I'm Athos.
I'm Athos.
All for one, one for two. You got my message?
No.
I understand somebody needs the help of the three brave musketeers. I think it's acting.
You're not sure, though, are
you?
No. We think it's acting, but we're not sure.
The Queen has had an indiscretion.
That 9 months went very quickly.
The Queen is here? What's that?
I think it's tension.
Oh. Do it to me, will you?
I'm sure you're both anxious to meet Her Majesty.
No.
Good, then follow me.
Certainly.
Over here.
Your Majesty, the Three Musketeers, at your service.
Your Majesty.
Mrs. King.
Please, be seated.
I understand that Your Majesty has a problem which only us musketeers can solve.
I am in love with the Duke of Buckingham.
Sacre bleu!
The Duke of Buckingham?
He's a married man with 15 children and a walking stick.
Does your husband, the King, know about this?
If the evil Cardinal Richelieu has his way, the King will know soon enough, and who's got his hand on my knee?
Sorry about that.
That scoundrel Richelieu!
The problem is this. Some time ago, the King gave Her Majesty 12 diamonds as a present.
Before the Duke of Buckingham left for England.
Yes?
I gave him a token of my love.
I bet he slept well on the boat.
No, I gave him the 12 diamonds.
And Cardinal Richelieu knows of this.
But the diamonds are in England.
Exactly. The Cardinal wishes to expose my feminine folly.
He can't do that. There's a frost about.
I beg of you to act with all speed.
One of us must go to England.
We'll let her go. She stood up.
Rest easy, Your Majesty. The musketeers will look after you.
Thank you.
We're the three musketeers for the brave are we. I'm Athos.
I'm Athos.
I'm Athos.
All for one, one for who?
Now that all will be well. I am very tired, and so I will bid you good night.
Good night, Your Majesty.
Good night, Your Majesty.
Good night, lads. Give us a call about 8:30 in the morning.
All right.
You want a cup of tea?
Hey? Come back here, you!
Pardon?
I've got to go and get the diamonds.
I beg of you to...
Nothing personal. What?
I beg of you to do all in your power to find my love. You must climb every hill and dale. If needs be, you must climb every mountain.
Yes.
Thank you.
Climb it.
Get off.
Sorry.
She must think this is opportunity knocks.
If it is, you'll have to be sponsored.
I'll go and do it now.
But let's get on with the play.
The problem is...
Otherwise...
Yes?
Let me get me lines. Otherwise, we'll be here till Christmas.
Till Christmas!
Till Christmas!
The problem is... The problem is, how do we get across to England?
How do we get across? That's quite a problem, I'll tell you.
It is.
Because we've got to get across the channel.
Yes.
And there's a bit of a storm brewing up.
I've got a dinghy.
Haven't we all?
Mine will hold three.
Amazing!
Congratulations. The thing we've got to do, though, is to get those diamonds back before the ball, you see. Because otherwise the King gets upset, because if he finds out what's going on, there's going to be terrible trouble.
It's a beautiful French accent, isn't it?
Cardinal Richelieu by now will know of our whereabouts. He has many spies in this part of the world.
Many spies?
That's true, that's true, William.
Aha, yes, you're right. The landlord, he has defected.
It's a draft mile. It's doing me no good, I'll tell you that.
He's obviously one of Richelieu's men. He's got to tell him that we're here with a queen.
Oh. Tish, I couldn't care less.
Oh, tosh. We will not bow the knee to that scoundrel.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We're three musketeers bold and brave. I'm Athos.
I'm Athos.
I'm Athos.
Wahoo, wahoo, wahoo.
Musketeers!
Aye!
Are we not the finest swordsmen in all Europe?
Aye!
Are we not the bravest of men?
Aye!
Drop your swords!
Aye!
I thought so, you miserable cowards.
You dare to call the musketeers cowards?
You are cowards. You will eat those words, Cardinal!
Yes. By my beard, we will fight you to the death.
You haven't got a beard.
Can I come back in 6 months?
Poor fools, you fools.
Fools?
You cannot win this little game. My men have this inn completely surrounded, and now you will never get to London.
But
or
what
England,
about...
even. England.
But what about the diamonds?
Ah, the diamonds, if you cannot get to London.
Or England.
Or England.
Yes.
You cannot get the diamonds.
Yes, sir.
We might not be able to get to London or England. But...
We're the three musketeers!
Thank you!
We're the three musketeers!
Thank you!
We're the three musketeers! Bald.
Thank you!
We're the three musketeers!
Bald.
We cut it out!
When?
We cut that bit out.
Mm-hmm.
He got tired, he couldn't do it.
Oh! We cut it out, that. Sorry about that, Cardi.
What's he up to?
I've got no idea! No idea.
We might not be able to go to England, but...
We can bring England to us. What trickery is this?
Look at me, Bill. Whereabouts? Whereabouts in England does the Duke of Buckingham live?
In Buckinghamshire.
Just testing you. And whereabouts is Buckinghamshire?
I think it's about there.
Ha! Give me the diamond. Thank you.
Get off.
No, that is Jimmy Clitheroe on his skin. Hand me those diamonds.
You'll have to kill us first.
You speak for yourself. Here.
You will pay for this with your lives.
But he is the fastest sword in the whole of France.
Yes, really.
Look at that. Look at that. You can't see the blade. Ha! Missed.
What's this then? Good Lord. Look at that. And three of them are butted.
On guard, Athos! On guard! On guard! On guard!
He yields! Well, were you for the best part?
Well done! Well done, my comrades!
What a battle that was!
Like a European cup match!
Oh, here are the diamonds. I must go. I am undone!
Yeah. Your Majesty!
Your Majesty.
Mrs. Monarch. The diamonds.
Recovered for you by the brave musketeers.
You must have your reward.
Reward?
Thank you. We'll go to the cellar.
For you, gentlemen of the musketeers. 150 English guineas in French money. And now I will take my leave of you.
Your Majesty, what? That's going to come in handy. That is one.
Yes, I'll say it.
I say, this is great.
That's £50 each, you know.
£50 each. Let's get it in the bag.
Just a minute.
I've heard in years.
That money is ours.
What are you talking about?
You owe us at least 50 guineas each.
Yes. Get off.
We've all done shows for these people and we haven't been paid.
What do you mean
you haven't been paid?
Take no notice, though. You work for these two, you're ruined for life and they never pay you.
Oh, we'll soon see you that. Come on, lads, we'll go and have a share out.
Yes. They never learned, do they?
No, they never learned.
All up into the same thing.
We better split this, eh? Yeah. One for you.
Anywhere, I will find you, don't care where. Look behind you, I'll be there, following you around. Rain or shine, you won't shake me, I don't mind. Where you take me, spend my time, following you around. Oh, listen, don't you know, hiding from me does no good. Wherever you may go, I'll be in the neighborhood. If you fly, I will follow, I don't care about tomorrow, long as I'm following you around. If you run, I'll run faster, gonna stick like a piece of plaster, get my kicks, following you around. Get my kicks, following you around. Get my kicks, following you around.
Eric Porter is an associate member of the Royal Shakespeare Company. Edward Woodward is a National Theatre player. Peter Cushing lives in Whitstable. William Franklin lives, but only just. And I, Eric Morecambe, am a fully paid-up member of the Ernie Wise Players.
There you are, sir.
112,000 miles on 1 gallon of economy petrol.
Yes.
Well, what do you think of that, sir?
Oh, the petrol is excellent. Good. It really is, but my car's clapped out now, isn't it?
Petrol is good, isn't it?
Yes, I mean, but my car's finished now after all that. Yes. Journey, isn't it? Pardon? My car's finished now, though, isn't it? Clapped out, my car.
Yes, yes, of course. I mean, the petrol, you...
Excellent. It's clapped out, yes. My car's. Do I get any compensation at all?